painting. I got a goofy by my convention. Hold me in my wallet, rock it, cause we rock with Disney. NFT frenzy, cop all that Disney. I flip my way up, hey, let's get busy. I'm with my game, yeah, family friendly. I play the game, yeah, and touch the milli. He call me Liddy, they rock with Disney. Don't go to moments, I need about 50. VeVe and Disney, they got them dizzy. We pass the moon, yeah, we gon' keep winning. Red dreams come true, for me and you. He call me did it, yeah, with the crew. I'm talking Dan and David Yu, Reese and Trevor. Alice too, just to name a few. He called me a beast, they put Disneyland in digital. I be on the VeVe, I just caught me an original. Had to trust the vision, but right now it's looking visible. He a paper head for the spread, it's so despicable. Ooh. We been going up like a missile do. Ooh. All they next moves unpredictable. Ooh. NFT flipper, why me run it up too? All these major brands on the middle boat. Ooh. IMX Disney NFT, I invest. Hold up, I just told my baby that we blessed. We was on it early than the rest. VeVe and Disney, NFT making. Don't go to moments. Man, I got plenty.
What's up, my OMI homies and fellow NFT collectors? Welcome back to the vault. Yesterday, VeVe released a Medium article going over the details of their Master Collectors program. So I thought I'd put out a quick video going over what I think are some of the most important details that we learned from this article and take a look at how we can earn the most points for the Master Collectors program per gem. One of the most important notes made in this article is right at the top. It says that this is a work in progress plan, which means that this is just a rough draft. They're putting it out there to get some feedback from the community to see what they think about it, and they'll possibly rework it in the future. So the Master Collectors program consists of three things, and that's rank, level, and points. Your rank is determined by your level, and your level is achieved by gaining points. So first off, we're going to look at how to gain those points. So you have two type of points that you can earn. You have those one-off points, and you have the recurring points. The one-off points are things that you earn one time once it happens, but the recurring points are points that you earn daily, every day, and they stack up over time. So when you're looking at the point totals earned, it's obvious to see that those one-off points are huge and they're very important. You only get them one time, but when you're looking at points of 100 compared to the reoccurrings of 5 and 6, then you can see that they're very important. And some of the ways that you can earn these one-off points are by onboarding new users. And I'm sure most of us have already had our family members signed up so that we had extra hands on drop day, but I don't think they're going to be able to go back and retroactively apply those points. So in the future, you're going to have to sign up your cousins and your friends and other people who haven't got to the app yet so you can get those 100 points, because that's big. You're going to get 100 points every time you complete a set, but of course, I'm assuming that that's only the first time you complete a set. You can't complete a set and then get rid of one of those collectibles out of the set so that it's incomplete and then buy the collectible back and get the 100 points again. It's a one-time thing, so it's probably going to be one time for each set that you complete. And of course, you're going to get those one-time points of 25 and 15 when you're making purchases on the app, either from the store or the market. And you can also gain one-time points for in-app activity every day, up to 25. And that's for simple things like liking stuff in the feed or posting your own thing or even posting stuff for sale on the marketplace. Another set of one-time points that we're going to be earning are from the badges. Now, every time we get a badge, which is completing an activity like doing something within the app, such as completing a set or maybe setting up a showroom, you're going to get a badge for that, and each badge is going to come with points, but they haven't said how much each of the badges are worth, so that's a variable that we don't know yet. The other type of points we're going to be receiving are the recurring points. Now, these are small values, but they're really big because they stack up over time. So you get 1 point for each collectible that you own, but that also means that you get 7 points per week for each collectible that you own. So if you got 100 collectibles, you're getting 700 points a week just for those. Of course, if you're stacking collectibles, they're not worth as much for the second and the third as it says in the article, so it's almost smart to get one of each collectible instead of buying a whole bunch of the same one that you like. And then in those recurring points, you also have your bonus points, and bonus points are for things like having a secret rare or an ultra rare or a rare. Each one of those rarities gives you those bonus points each day. Like I said, some people are upset that the secret rares aren't worth more each day, but they have the monetary value. You get the monetary value from that, and that doesn't necessarily correlate with Master Collector points. So it seems fair to me since it's only one NFT, but that's something that they might rework in the future. You can also get bonus recurring points for low edition, low serial NFTs, which I think is really cool. That's obviously something that they listen to the community about, and they're given a half bonus point each day for collectibles with a sub number 150 mint. Now that means below 150, so if you have serial number 150, you wouldn't get that bonus, but if you have 149 or lower, you would. However, with the comics, you get the same type of bonus for your low serial numbers, and it's the first 150 available to the public, so you have to look to see where the serial numbers start on that. But you can see there where, how they say it's the first 150 available on that one. If you did have that last serial number in the set, let's say it starts at 200 and you got serial number 350, you would actually get those bonus points the way it's written there, unlike the collectibles, where it starts at 149. And then you have your daily recurring bonus points for each set that you've completed. The big sets with 5 collectibles or more are 6 points each, and then you go down from there, 5 points for 4 collectible sets, and then 3.5 for 3 collectibles, 2.5 for 2 collectibles, and you only get 1.5 points for those 1 collectible sets like Superman. If you check out this newly created website by a community member called VeVeSetlist.com, you can see here the Master Collector's point values of each set, and it even shows about the price range of to purchase that set. It's very helpful. I'll put the link down in the description. You also get a small bonus for sets that you have more of, the duplicate sets, but you don't get as much of a bonus as you get for duplicate collectibles that you own. So owning more than one of the same set really isn't helping you a whole lot in the Master Collector's program points. The way the point system is set up for the comics is pretty much the same. You're going to get 1 point every day for each comic that you own, and you're going to get those bonus points for the rares, the ultra rares, and the secret rares. The bonus points they have set up for the comics, though, works a little differently. You don't complete a set and get those 5 bonus points every day by having each rarity of one particular comic. You instead would have to have 1 copy of any rarity of each comic that was released in a series, and you only get it if that series has released at least 3 comics. So in this case right now, we only have Amazing Spider-Man, which is released number 1, number 50, and number 361 onto the VeVe app. So that's the only one that you can actually get those 5 bonus points for right now. But you can assume in the future they're going to be releasing at least 3 of each of the sets, so it's probably smart to stock up on those comics. And right now, the best deal for your money on getting MC points through gems is to buy the Amazing Spider-Man number 1, number 50, and number 361 comics. You can get all 3 of those for about $80, and you're going to get 8 recurring points every day for that, 1 for each of the comics, and then 5 for having 1 of each copy of the comic in that series. Alright guys, another important thing to think about with these Master Collector Program details are the retroactive points that we're going to be awarded for all the time we've been into VeVe. All of those are going to come right at the same time when Master Collector's Program begins. And as you can see here, points have a shelf life of 6 months. So at the very beginning of Master Collector's Program, there's going to be a whole lot of people that have a whole lot of points, and they're going to have to spend them kind of fast. Looking at the roadmap, you can see that the drop lotteries come before the accessories. So it's possible that those first drop lotteries, there's going to be really high point values being spent on them. And you might want to save your points later on before your 6 months is up. And hopefully those accessories will be released, because I personally don't want to gamble my points on a drop lottery. I'd rather spend them on accessories. However, if they have a shelf life of 6 months, then you have to spend them or lose them. The drop lottery system is actually pretty complicated. I'm not 100% sure how it's going to work, but it looks like users are going to be able to gamble as much of their MCP points as they want on a drop lottery. And if they've wagered more than anybody else and they're on that top tier, then they're able to purchase that NFT on the drop without having to click fast or get in there before anybody else. Of course, every drop lottery will be different. It'll depend on the collectible being dropped at that time and the edition size. So there's still a lot of variables to calculate before you decide if you want to participate in a drop lottery or not. Lastly, I did want to mention the MCP Pro section. Now that looks really cool. I think everybody should get into this because the benefits you receive are awesome. First off, you get to display your rarity and edition number, not only in your showroom, but also in augmented reality. Whether you're a low serial collector or a vaultaholic who likes to make art in their vaults, this is going to come in very handy for sure. You also get an auto bid feature if you're part of the MCP program, and that's going to be cool as well. You're going to be able to set a price that you want to pay for a collectible, and it's going to automatically bid for you anytime the price is lower than the set amount. You also get access to exclusive content, which apparently includes collectibles, so possibly NFTs that you can only obtain if you're part of MCP Pro, so that's a reason to get in it for sure. And then it even says that you may be able to burn collectibles for points, which is going to reduce the supply on certain collectibles and lead to a lot of cool things happening in the marketplace. So we got a lot of interesting information from this article, and we can definitely use what we've learned to modify our collecting strategies on the VeVe app. Hope this video was helpful for you. Feel free to join my Discord if you want to talk about the Master Collectors Program and VeVe more. I'll put the link down in the description, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.